Tony did this.
And what a fine piece of equipment it is. You got a snap ring.
And a bearing. And what are the chances that he's got a snap ring and a bearing in stock needed for this project?
That's the wrong way.
You're the one that found all the stuff and made it, put it together.
That's the wrong bearing. So what you do with the bearing that goes on the end?
You wouldn't let me use it. You told me to go home. I'm going to use that bearing over, go home. And then you grabbed this one.
No, I did not.
It's around here somewhere.
It used to be in this box.
Well, I didn't take it.
Well, I didn't eat it.
It.
So we got a problem now, Bubba.
I don't know where it is.
Well.
So what's the chances of him not having a bearing?
No bearing, no assembly.
Well, yeah, usually. I got it all ready. But I'll need those to put again. As soon as you find that bearing. Doesn't fit here either, does it? You even did all that measuring and cutting on a lathe? You sure? Are you sure the bearing is not here? Here's my old one.
Hey, dipstick. Somebody laid it on top of you.
Oh, so now I'm the dipstick. So I can't even reach that high. He's gonna club me with it soon. You sure that's the right bearing?
Nope. We'll make it fit.
Drive her home.
Would you use a bigger hammer? This is not the right way to do it, but I have to. Anytime you work with a clown like that,
my big red nose that gives it away. Which way is that supposed to go? I got a snap ring.
We do.
I wonder what's going to break next. Because this is not going to break. Uh-oh. Spatter. Where's the file? Get a half round file? Right. Get spatter inside here.
What you do that for, Jeff?
See, it's all my fault.
Yeah.
Now what are you gonna do?
Clean it up.
Isn't that what I asked for? Didn't I ask for a half round file?
Ew, he's got to look at himself. It fit!
That'll do.
Whoa! Now we have to be careful.
He's getting old, he amazes himself sometimes. I just wonder what I'm gonna lube it with now.
You don't.
What about that?
You don't. Why would you want to lube that?
Because that's the way it was made?
You were lubing it because of that bearing. This is a sealed bearing. It doesn't need lubrication.
Not the way you're supposed to do that either.
Nope.
It's bouncing. It must be down all the way.
Yep.
Hey, what about that Woodruff key?
I'll get it in there. I'll have enough room.
Once this is all fixed in proper working order, that's the time to sell it. So I got hay to do.
About time.
Well, if it'll quit raining.
Use your umbrella.
I tried that once. The hay still got wet.
You know, you're full of excuses. That's all I can say. Woo! It turns!
I didn't hear it rub anything.
Well, we did something wrong. See, we do this. We don't have to use a cutter pin.
So break out the torch the next time it needs to come apart. I don't have any problem with breaking out the torch when I need to get something apart. Click. It's about tight enough, I would think. I'll throw about another 100 pound of torque on there, Tony.
Okay. Now, one thing I would do...
Fill a hole and put a Zerk in.
Right. So you can lubricate this shaft.
Yep. It went all the way through.
I know. But you don't need...
I know that.
Really?
Well, if that happens to make contact at some point, that sucker's gonna gall up and... Never happen?
Nope.
How many thousands of clearance did you put on it?
I have no idea. It clears.
It clears. It's okay.
But why didn't you drill a hole in it before you put it together? Would have been a whole lot easier.
I wasn't the wild man on the welder.
I said, why didn't you drill and tap a hole in it before you assembled it?
I'll have to play back the footage and find out just how all that happened. So we got our two pins for the other necessities. One pin for this necessity. Shaft bolted in. Got a bearing. I'm going to have to repair this before I can slide it on the shaft after Kitchen Magician here mushroomed it over. Are we done? Oh, you're going to drill and tap it. Okay, let's do that. My, what a large vise you have.
Big enough gun work.
What am I doing now? You can get that fixed, you know.
A what?
You can get that fixed, you know.
What?
We're in business.
Put some grease in it.
All right. Got our pins. We're all back together. It's time to go make the rake. Thank you, Tony.
You're welcome.
How much was this? About 500 bucks on this one, isn't it? Somewhere around there. Well, at this point, everything's pretty much greased up and ready to be put back together. So, I guess that's what I'll do. While Tony was playing around over there, I was straightening these rods up. If you've seen last year's hay field follies, you know what these used to look like. I'm not going to do it all over again. So my theory is, since that's about the same space there, that's where that goes. But I do have an issue. This little collar is supposed to go in there. I'll get to that after I assemble everything else. The other thing I have to find out is where the shaft's supposed to ride in relationship to the tractor. But I'm going to guess, it used to be down here. So I'm going to guess that's a good starting point. Seems my metal forming is not quite dimensionally correct. But it soon will be. Been a long time since it looked that good. That'll do. Well, see if we can put some tacky weld on here. Or tack weld. Connect the blobs. By Jove, it almost looks like it will work. But wait, there's more. It actually worked. Flat enough. Much tighter than it used to be. So then, also put a bracket on down here. When you put the pin through, it doesn't cock when you're trying to move around. So, the only thing that remains to be done, get the tractor over here and hook the PTO up. I had a can of 50-50 gas diesel mix that you use for starting brush fires. Well, I get some gas one day, grab the can, put it in the tractor. There's really nothing wrong with the tractor until it burns the rest of that fuel. It smelled like gas. Let's hold back and work your order. Hear that noise? Me neither. And that's the way, I like it, So, hopefully that does it for the only episode of the 2015 Cane Field Follies. Because I don't need another episode. I gotta get hay done. And for Redneck Restoration System Truck and UpwardIron.com. So with the welder on the lowest setting it has, see if we can burn a hole through this tin. No, we can't, because it doesn't feed the wire. It's moving, huh? That's a clawless hammer, isn't it?
Yeah, clawless. Clueless.
What are you trying to say? Ooh, zoom. Faster, maybe. A little paint, you think of the factory. Oh, I gotta bring it over there. That sounds about. It'll do. He absolves himself of all wrongdoing. Let's see. I have everything I need. I got that. This. Got this. Got one of these. Three of these. One of these. What happened here?